Prospects are bright for the Philippine karate team in the upcoming Southeast Asian Games here in the Philippines. The national team won 8 medals in a recent tournament in Turkey, which is part of their training for the 30th SEA Games. And here with us is the president of the Philippine Karate Federation, Mr. Ricky Lim, and female karateka Jamie Berabe Lim, the daughter of Philippine basketball legend, the Skywalker Samboy Lim. Jamie and Mr. Ricky, thank you so much for joining us here on the program. So we're really wishing the best for the Philippine karate team under new leadership. Yeah. Sir Ricky, so how is the team preparing now so far for the Southeast Asian Games?
Before we start, I just like to correct, it's Karate Filipinas.
Karate Filipinas, yeah. Alright, okay, go ahead.
We're preparing, well, the team went to Turkey, the kumite team went to Turkey for 2 months, and the kata team trained in Japan for 2 months. They're back here, and they're now housed in Ultra. So they're not going home, they're training full time.
So how big was that tournament in Turkey where Philippines bagged 8 medals?
Well, it's like a national championships in Turkey. We were the only ones that are not Turkish there in the competition. So it's really big. And for us to win and to be invited, it was an honor.
Okay, so Jamie, of course, you bagged medals also against a tough home crowd. Kumusta naman yung preparations or make that yung tournament dun sa Turkey, and how is it now boosting your confidence coming into the SEA Games?
So I started training po after I graduated in college. So I started in July, and syempre mahirap po kasi I stopped for 4 years in college. It was hard, twice a day, every day training except for Sundays. It was very hard physically, mentally, so I had to focus po talaga. But the coach is very good, the team is very we inspire each other and we lift each other up. So it's very it's better for us to it's easier for us to survive the training because of that feeling po in the training.
Now Jamie, you mentioned that you had a gap during your college years. You actually started way too early having in a sports background. So can you tell us more about your story in your younger years? Why did you stop, and now you're competing for the Philippines?
Yes, well, I was 6 years old when I started. My parents actually made me po. I tried a lot of sports, but they made me stay in karate because my coaches told me to. They told me to compete and just stay and try it out. So I continued all the way up to 18 years old, and I decided to stop po because I wanted to focus on my academics this time in college.
You took up?
BS Mathematics po in UP Diliman.
Okay.
So, idol ko po si Daddy, Samboy Lim, he's the Skywalker, and super idol ko po siya as an athlete, and si Mommy, idol ko rin po. Summa cum laude din po siya ng UP, philosophy naman po siya. So, I wanna be just like both of them po. So, I aspired to be Summa for the whole 4 years po. So, I decided focus talaga, the same amount of focus I give to karate, I gave to school po. And now, I graduated, and saktong-sakto po, SEA Games. So I decided I'll give it a go because it was always my dream to be national team din po when I was young. And so I just gave it a shot and
yes,
let's go.
And now we're here. All right, yes, so Ricky, now it's still not yet final, the final pool.
Yes.
Make that the final lineup. But
yes.
How are Jamie's teammates now preparing? It's going to be a tough battle to complete that lineup.
Well, actually, going back 6 months ago, I'm very excited. I can see the changes and the toughness of the team. Talagang solid sila ngayon. Bonding at the same time, training. They're one unit sila ngayon, and they're like a family now. So that is the strength of the team.
As a former national team member, yeah, won a gold in the SEA Games in 1989 and 1991. Yeah. How is it, you know, over the years that you've observed during your time as a competitor and now as head of the federation, What is the SEA Games like in the sport?
Well, SEA Games it's a big thing for us Southeast Asian people, no? Kasi it's a government to government championship, so it's supported by the government, and everybody's watching. So it's really very important. Although it's just 11 countries, but again, the pressure is there because everybody's looking at you.
So who are the toughest competitors?
Well, we have Indonesia, Malaysia, Vietnam, basically for karate,
uh-huh,
these three.
All right. So now, Jamie, that you're coming back, yeah. right? So have you competed against athletes from the nations or from the countries?
No, the last time I think I played against them was 2012. That was my last international competition. Because since July, I only joined 3 international competitions and 2 of them were in Turkey. So usually Turkish po and European countries yung mga nakalaban ko in the past month.
All right, so now, can you explain to us, 4-year rest, 4-year gap, is there a little bit of rust now? And at the same time, your conditioning, your level of conditioning, and now your experience coming into these games?
In the start, definitely. As in, I felt it in the very first training, sa jogging, sa sprints, nawawalan po ako ng air agad because it was so hard. I mean, 4 years of just studying and minimum fitness activity.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
But since push lang po ako ng push and okay naman yung training po, the training program is very effective. I think grabe po yung improvement, especially from Turkey po.
I just have to ask this, of course, wishing well and prayers up to your father, the Skywalker Samboy Lim. I just want to ask, how is his condition and how does he still motivate you, you know, to do your best?
Yeah,
in
so
game?
Si Daddy nagka heart attack po in 2014, and right now he's still bedridden, but we can communicate with him because he can understand us. So he can cry when we say sad stories and he can laugh when we say funny stories. He still remembers a few instances, memories po, it's still there. So just by being there and like being able to tell him what's going on with my life and I see his small reactions, I mean, it inspires me and motivates me to win it for him po.
And I'm sure coming in to this games, yeah. Rather, I'm just going to come back to your childhood story. Mm-hmm. There was a point in time that you tried every sport,
yes,
right?
Po, yes.
So, was there basketball also in mind for you? But
yes.
How did you choose karate?
Oh, basketball was there po. So, I tried a lot like gymnastics, swimming, basketball a lot. Eh, si mommy po, nakita niya in the basketball camp, daddy's basketball camp. Sabi niya, Jamie's the only girl out of 100 boys, so parang maybe not this.
Okay.
And so karate is what we stuck with because of my coaches. They were very strict, so they told me to just stay even though I wasn't the best yet at 6 years old.
All right.
So, yeah.
All right. So now coming in, Mr. Ricky, it's going to be a fresh start for the federation. Mm-hmm. At the same time, how can we grow the sport still in the Philippines?
Well, we have grassroots level, no? So we go out in the different regions. We have local championships, and then there's this the PSC's Batang Pinoy, then the DepEd's Palarong Pambansa, which we might be joining for the next year's Palarong Pambansa,
okay,
as a demo sport karate. So these are the grassroots level. Now for the higher level, like for the cadets, juniors, and seniors, we have annual championships for the Asia, for the world, and we're preparing for the Olympics now for the 2020. It's the first time karate will be an Olympic sport. So it will be held in, of course, we all know, in Tokyo. So we have a final qualifying in Paris this coming May, and there's a pretty good chance we have about 2 or 3 players going in.
And how can the Filipinos support Karate Pilipinas in the Southeast Asian Games?
Oh, please come and watch us in the coming Southeast Asian Games. We're going to be at the World Trade Center from December 7 to 9. So please come and support the Philippine team.
All right. So Mr. Ricky Lim and Jamie Lim from Karate Pilipinas, maraming salamat. Thank you so much and good luck for the 30th Southeast Asian Games.
Thank you.
Thank you.